cross him personally, officially, or through his writings. I just want to share a couple of things I learned from him as a son. One, I observed that power and influence that comes from positions and postings is temporary. It is easy to forget that. What lasts is goodwill and a reputation. Though he was an atheist, he always believed in sticking to what is right and ethical, however difficult the consequences. For instance, when I told him about my wanting to marry Rajeshwari, he warned her about my habits and asked her to reconsider her decision. And when we had major problems in our marriage, he supported his daughter-in-law in every way rather than his son.
Now I request Sandhya to speak a few words about her father.
So I want to start by saying, reciting this two lines from, I'm not sure whether it's Shelley or Keats, but I found it in his notes on the death of a friend of his. He wrote this down. It says, "Peace, peace, he is not dead. He doth not sleep. He has awakened from the dream of life." So, next I want to express how we feel. And this is especially for my mother. It's by the poet Edna St. Vincent Millay. He and I liked her very much. Mommy? Time does not bring relief. You all have lied. Who told me time would ease me of my pain? I miss him in the weeping of the rain. I want him at the shrinking of the tide. The old snows melt from every mountainside, and last year's leaves are smoke in every lane. But last year's bitter loving must remain, heaped on my heart, and my old thoughts abide. There are 100 places where I fear to go, so with his memory they brim. And entering with relief some quiet place where never fell his foot or shone his face, I say, there is no memory of him here, and so stand stricken, so remembering him. Thank you all for coming.
And we used to play, he even used to play parlor with me, and cricket, and all the things that a father or a sibling would play. And on the last day that I met him, he was lying in the ICU, and I spoke to him about all these memories that we shared together, and I said, "Anna, you know, we've had some really beautiful memories." And he said, "Yes." And I said, "Aapko yaad hai, aap mujhe sher sunate the. Do you want to recite them with me now?" So he said, "Yes." So lying there in the hospital bed, we recited a couple of sher, a few of his favorites.